TCPython has been expanded for the 2019A release to include coverage of all Thermo-Calc product functionality, meaning that it can now be used for all calculation types. This is the first Thermo-Calc API that works with Scheil solidification simulations, precipitation module calculations, and diffusion module calculations, giving it complete coverage of Thermo-Calc functionality. TCPython is a Python-based API that allows users to openly couple Thermo-Calc calculations with other software using the easy-to-learn programming language Python. The SDK is built in Python because it is a widely used programming language in the scientific community, giving Thermo-Calc users access to many other libraries. For example, you can use numerical packages like NumPy and SciPy in combination with our calculations, as well as more easily do parallel computations. It is also possible to use TCPython conveniently from Jupyter notebooks. TCPython can also be used to couple to other simulation tools, allowing you to calculate, for example, finite element, fluid dynamics, and phase field simulations. This makes TCPython an integral part of the Integrated Computational Materials Engineering Framework, also known as ICME. TCPython acts as a crucial link in the ICME chain by providing all calculation types that are possible within Thermo-Calc and allowing users to, for instance, chain different simulation tools, providing input into Thermo-Calc and delivering the result to other software. Import and export the results of calculations from or into virtually any file format that is supported by a Python library. Solve high-level tasks that were not possible previously, for example, using precipitation calculations within an optimization routine to find the best-fitting interfacial energy. Run batch calculations for many varied parameters, and more. TCPython guides users through the process of setting up a simulation, offering good default values if you are unsure of what to set, and prompting you to include missing information, minimizing the occurrence of errors, and making it an easy option even for those who do not have experience working with APIs. The API uses an object-oriented approach, which helps prevent users from making mistakes and makes it easier to reuse information, such as classes and methods, and more quickly run your calculations when, for example, you need to change the compositions. I will show you a quick overview of the TCPython workflow to give you an idea of how easy it is to use the program. In order to run TCPython, you must download two companion programs, an integrated development environment, also known as an IDE, and a Python distribution, such as Anaconda. For information on which companion programs are needed and how to install them, visit the TCPython page on our website, which includes an installation video and quick install guide, as well as recommendations for free software programs. We recommend using PyCharm Community Edition, which is a free IDE, and we will use that throughout this video. However, you can use your preferred IDE. The workflow begins by opening PyCharm or whichever IDE you are using. Note that you do not need to open Thermo-Calc to use TCPython. If your program was set up correctly, you will see several examples for the diffusion module, the precipitation module, property models, and Thermo-Calc. To run any of the examples, right-click on one and select Run and the name of the example. For instance, Py example T3. You will see the example running in the events log, and if it completes correctly, a window will appear with the plots. The examples files can also be used as a starting point to create your own calculations. Right-click on the example you want to use and select Copy. Decide where you want to put your calculation, right-click there, and select Paste. Rename the file and select OK. You can start editing the file directly. You can also easily set up your own calculations. I will show you a basic but complete configuration for a diffusion simulation, which is composed of just a few lines of code. First, we must create a new directory and file. Right-click on the project pane, highlight New, and select Directory. Name your directory and select OK. Then right-click on the new directory, highlight New, and select Python file. Name the new file and select OK. We will start by importing TCPython and matplotlib, which will be used later for plotting. TCPython calculations are centered around setting up your session, which manages all the resources. Next, we load our databases exactly as we do in all other APIs. We will load both a thermodynamic and a kinetic database. TCPython was designed to offer powerful, intelligent code completion. For example, when we create a system object, such as this one, which contains the database with all the standard configurations, if we type a dot, we get a list with all the methods that are available in TCPython that are relevant for that object. We can even show the documentation for that method by typing Control Q. This is the exact documentation that is included with the software as HTML and PDFs. As you set up your calculation, the IDE provides information about the method parameters you need to use for this specific method. If the information is not shown automatically, you can access it by putting your mouse point within the parameter parentheses and typing Control P. We can see that we need to set temperature, so we will set it to 1400 Kelvin. I will now set up the rest of the calculation using best practices styling, and you can see the intelligent code completion appearing automatically. Here we add the actual calculation. Finally, we add the plot and configure it so that we can see the results. Once the calculation is set up, right-click anywhere within the editor window and select Run Video. You will see your calculation running in the events log, and once the calculation is complete, a window will appear with your plots. This plot shows a single isothermal diffusion calculation. The TCPython installation comes with complete detailed documentation in both PDF and HTML formats. You can access it from within Thermo-Calc in the Help menu, Manuals folder. For the PDFs, select Software Development Kits, TCPython API Programmer Guide. For the HTML version, go back out to the Manuals folder and select TCPython, then double-click on index.html. The help contains a lot of information, including an architecture overview, which shows you how to set up calculations, troubleshooting, and an extensive best practices section. If you have not already installed TCPython and the accompanying programs, watch our installation video to learn how to set up the program. If you have already installed the programs, use the included examples to get started using the software. If you do not have a license for TCPython, contact us at info@thermocalc.com to learn more, or visit us at thermocalc.com and visit the TCPython page.